Hey, I'm Catherine Hardwick, and this is The Breakdown. It is kind of like a very sort of provocative tale about technology and self-discovery. What makes you human? Is it, how deep does that go? Is it skin deep? Is it emotional intelligence? So it's quite provocative, I think, to explore these themes of technology and humanity.
That's cymatics, patterns created through vibrational frequencies.
Sometimes the teenage years are like the most volatile and most dynamic years, where it's like the first time you're allowed to drink a beer or kiss a girl or kiss a guy or drive a car. When I'm working with young actors, I'm trying to create an environment that they feel good and they feel like they can express to me what feels right and natural and real. Helen Howard, she's so raw and beautiful and you know, emotional. She just dove into the character in such a beautiful way. She had that great movie Madeline at Sundance last year. Don Cheadle, you know, and Emily Mortimer contributed so much. They liked these characters, I think, because they'd never played characters like this, these complex, you know. Emily's a scientist, sort of like a mad scientist, but I just loved what the actors did.
We can't keep doing this. It's not right.
There's no choice. If she becomes aware, it's only a matter of time before they become aware.
We are seeing a lot of cool things on streamers and premium cable where stories are going deeper into the internal lives of young people. That's fantastic, you know. I've had so many people say to me that when they saw 13, when they were growing up, that's the first time they felt like a connection, and it spoke to them. So the fact that there are more diverse voices out there telling more stories helps people feel more connected, you know, and find I'm not the only person that's going through this suffering or pain or anxiety. Yeah, there's another person that went through that too. There's somebody else too that went through that.
Come on, we're late.
I hung out with Carrie.
Levi and I conspired about our weekend.
In this show, there are a lot of challenges creating that near future, that different characters that have different levels of AI intelligence. You have certain kind of robots, some that are more advanced than others. So that was an interesting nuance. Also, to keep it grounded visually, not take you out of the movie too much, to you know, create those little details that felt like where our future could be going, but not go all the way to, you know, everything's perfect, clean, sci-fi, white, gleaming walls. There were just a lot of neat subtleties that we were trying to kind of figure out while we were doing this.
And it all went to shit.
One thing that was pretty fascinating is that it has to be viewable in the vertical and the horizontal format. And in art school or whatever, we've all, of course, done paintings in a portrait format, but I've never tried to compose shots with like two people, cinematic shots in a vertical format. So for myself and the cinematographer, Patrick Murguia, big challenge, you know, how do you have two people talking, you know, to each other and still in that narrow frame? And it turned out that, you know, it actually becomes quite intimate. Like if you're watching it in a landscape format, yeah, you get to see the whole environment and how it affects the character. And maybe you can see somebody else like sneaking up in different layers. But then when you turn it this way, and it's kind of your choice as a viewer, you can turn it vertical, and now you're almost maybe forced to be more focused on the emotions of that character. So it becomes very intimate, almost like you're FaceTiming with that person or something. So you get to make a choice. And, you know, we had to think about all that. That was a super interesting challenge while filming.
Does she know where she came from?
Hi, my name is Aisha.
I hope it is kind of thrilling, because for me, there were some things that were really exciting reveals and, you know, scary stuff too. And I hope it's a good ride. I hope you do fall in love with the characters and the diversity of characters. And I hope it does, you know, kind of expand your mind and you can think about that, you know, question, what does it mean to be human and how is technology affecting our lives now? And how much do we embrace it? How much do we fight it? How much does it frustrate us? Or how much do we love it because it gives us all these awesome tools? And in our ongoing push-pull with technology.